It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we've got some history in this battle of AFL alumni. It's the Tennessee Titans and the Los Angeles Chargers, and it's coming up next on Madden Football.
It was only opened in 2020, but quickly became one of the league's most recognizable venues. We're looking at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California. Welcome to another entertaining matchup, folks. Kate Scott, Brock Huard on the call in this one. Brock, a couple running backs down on the field who can really take over their offenses when they get in the groove.
And I think that's going to be the ultimate goal of both of these offenses, right? I mean, there's just no confusion about it. They want to get their bell cow in that groove and get them going. Find that rhythm where they're ripping off chunk yardage run after run, and then just keep on feeding that beast. In a game like this, whichever offense can get that rhythm and run game going first is likely going to be your winner.
Here to begin this one is Cameron Dicker. And here we go from L.A. Julius Chestnut to return. This return makes it up to the 25. So the Titans ready for their opening drive of the game. And leading them out is their second-year quarterback from Kentucky. He earned several starts as a rookie. It's Will Levis.
I would argue the NFL today is populated with some of the best athletes playing quarterback we have ever seen, and Will fits into that mold. He's big and strong, and he had a breakout debut with 4 touchdown passes a year ago in his opener. The challenge was the consistency, and that was for the entire team. He's hoping year 2 and gaining on that rookie experience can help him take that next step.
Right to the air, it's Levis. Brought in by Westbrook Akine. And he's caught after a game about 2. Christian Fulton the one to bring him down.
Textbook hitch route. Sit him in the short field and deliver it once that defense turns their attention elsewhere. Okay, this is a low ceiling play, but a reliable source of yardage.
From the 27, he's on the move. He takes it himself. And he protects himself for the slide there after a decent game.
Tick, 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 tick. You know, his internal clock right there told him it was time to escape, and good thing he listened to it. He was able to make something out of nothing and at least move them forward.
Third down, 1 yard to go. Levis now off the play fake. Has the connection to Ridley. And he's down. Looks like they made the stop at the 46-yard line. Big gainer here as he picks up 20. And that'll be a Tennessee first down.
If they get a handful of these types of plays per game, the pass game coordinator is going to be one happy camper.
New set of downs for him from the 46. Levis here on first down. Drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
And look at that. All that effort and success from the previous play, it is gone. Credit to this defense who snapped and clear. That's part of this game. You got to snap and clear. Give up a big play, come back and make a big one for yourself. And they do get home that side.
Offense to the line for second down. First carry here for Tony Pollard. He's forward, gets a couple of yards. That's Denzel Perryman in on the stop. Only a couple there, hoping obviously for considerably more. And that's going to bring up third and very long. On the play fake, it's Levis. Okonkwo brings it in. And he's going to be across midfield, close to the 45 before going out.
You know, I like the completion. You never turn down a completion. That's just not the right throw to make in that spot to move the chains.
The Titans sending out Ryan Stonehouse now on fourth down to in turn and send a punt away. This punt out of bounds on the fly, waiting for the mark. Looks like they're going to say it's just short of the 30. So now out comes the Charger offense for their initial drive of the game. They'll be led out by the fifth-year pro who can really fill up a stat sheet, Justin Herbert.
Hey, let's be honest. The only reason the Chargers drafted in the top five was because Justin Herbert wasn't available all season long. An injury cut short his year, but it really didn't cut short his production while he was playing. Still over 3,000 yards and 20 touchdowns. Kid, I can tell you, this is one guy that I love. I mean, I love to watch throw a football.
Here's first and 10 from the 34. First run of the game for J.K. Dobbins. He gets it forward for a gain of 3. That was Harold Landry making the tackle. Give him a few yards on that run. It's 2nd and 7. Again, they'll run with Dobbins. To the ground, but nothing gained that time, and it brings up 3rd and 7.
So close to a big loss of yards for those guys up front. 1 second sooner, and they got a tackle behind the line, but a stop to celebrate nonetheless.
The tight end going in motion right. On 3rd down, Herbert. That's complete to Dobbins. And he'll head out of bounds after a short gain.
When there's heat, that blitz coming off the snap, that QB's eyes, you could see it right away. He got to his check down in a hurry. But, Kate, here's the key. Quarterback and running back have to be on the same page. The two were right there, and it netted some positive yards.
Punter takes the field on 4th down, and he sends this one flying. Begins his return at the 16. And he's brought down before the return gets far. Now, elsewhere on the return, there's an injured player in need of some attention, which he will get as trainers head his way. Drive will start out with a 1st and 10. Throwing now off play action. That's going to be caught. Tony Pollard. Pick up of a few as he heads out of bounds.
Sure showed off some mobility on that play. Got outside the pocket and easily found an open man.
They'll come to the line here. 2nd and 9. Gun, Levis. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact. Well-timed strike by that defender to knock it free. And things look tougher now with 3rd and long.
See the pass, time up your hit, and jar that ball loose. Not a lot of players are hanging on through a well-placed hit like that one.
Throwing is Levis on 3rd down. Complete beyond the marker. And they've got a fresh set of downs.
If only every completion could get that kind of result. That's good enough to knock a defense flat on its back.
So the big play gets them just beyond midfield. It's 1st down. Play fake, he's gonna throw. Pass taken in by Pollard. Head out of bounds after a small game.
Some certainly do it better than others, Kate, but every running back in the league today has got to do just that. You cannot be a one-dimensional back in the league anymore. You can't. You gotta be able to handle your business, both tote the ball as a runner, and really importantly, as a check down outlet on short throws.
Levis throwing again. And they make the stop. We're going to say it about the 37-yard line. So after that completion, we've got a player in some visible discomfort. And here come the trainers to get him some help. battle coming up on third and inches. Up the middle, here goes Pollard. And he's able to drive this to the 29 before the stop. Give him 8 yards on the play. And the Titans will have a first down.
That's a BYOB. You got to be your own blocker. It would have taken the entire defense piling on to stop him from getting that first down. Well done.
Throwing now on first down, Levis. Short throw is dropped. This one's incomplete.
I think everybody on the offense was already thinking about the next play to run as they watched that short little throw to the tight end. You really don't expect to see many of those gimmies dropped.
Couldn't connect on first. It's second down. They go play action here. Has it at the 7. And that's a Tennessee touchdown. So, Brock, this offense starting to find its rhythm a bit as they finish things with a touchdown there to give them the lead.
And the key word there that you said is finish, because you want to have that mindset, even early in the game, that field goals aren't going to cut it. So that's great work to make sure they finish with 6 points.
Nick Folk now for the extra point. Right down the middle, it's good. And the Titans will jump out to a 7-0 lead. Stonehouse now to kick this one away. Darius Davis to return it. And pretty solid field position starting out here, Brock. He's tackled at the 29. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Track him down after a small game.
Well, that's a tough one because you could see the beginnings of what looked like an explosive play. Let's give some credit here, Kate, to the defense. A great job to bottle him up before it came to fruition.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Play action now for Herbert. They send it in the hands of Will Disley. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. Does a gain of 25 yards and picks up the first.
Every tight end worth his salt wanted this. Really craved man-to-man coverage. The best of them, give me man-to-man coverage and I'm gonna beat you. I was around Dallas Clark and Indy, one of the best. You play man-to-man, he's gonna find a way to out-leverage you, separate from you, and make a play just as that tight end did.
Throwing on first is Herbert. Hurst there to grab it. They're working a couple yards past the line. Monty Hooker with the tackle.
Well, that's a modest little drag route, but if you ever just need a safe short gain on the throw, that's a go-to route to target.
8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. Takes off right out of the read option. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
Any tackle for loss hurts, Kate, but they hurt that much more from a defensive back. Those guys typically are better in coverage, and you got to find a way to make a miss in the backfield.
Drive in dire straits. It's 3rd and 9. Herbert from the gun. He's got it over the middle, and he's able to reach the 40 on that play.
Feet and eyes, Kate. Feet and eyes, they so often tell the story of every position on the field. When that quarterback's feet and eyes move to his secondary read, and so often it's a tight end, well, it's incumbent on that defense to fly to the ball. You want to make that tackle, force the fourth down? It took a great defensive effort to do it.
Fourth down, and on comes the punt team, and the kick's away. Drive starts out with a first and 10. They'll begin with a quick completion to the right side. And he's able to get across the 25 before stepping out. Second and 6 coming up here. Levis to the air now. Pass caught by Ridley. They get 27 on the play. And that'll be a Tennessee first down.
That's just a gorgeous corner route by the wide receiver. I bet you'll find, Kate, in the annals of football history, the best corner route runners as receivers. We're also the best slant runners, the best post runners, because it's all about change of direction, and that was put on display right there.
Football on that 47-yard line, first down. Throwing is Levis. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free, incomplete.
You know, he might complete 99 out of 100 of those short, simple routes to the tight ends. Even the shortest and simplest of throws, it's due to end up in a drop at some point.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Here he goes on the bootleg. Caught by Westbrook Akine. And a nice game here, but it stopped short of the first. Just 2 to go. Looking to throw, Levis. Run in right side. And he's tackled with a first down yardage.
Well, they got him down before he could do any more damage in terms of yards. That's no easy job, mind you, tackling a big tight end. But the main damage had already been done. He kept this drive going by getting beyond the line of gain.
First and 10 now from the 30. Levis now off the play fake. Rolling out to his left. Oh, look at this. Here he goes. And he works this to the 15 before they make the stop. He picks up 15 on the play. And the Titans will have a first down.
Well, there was no sense in taking a risk down the field when a first down was just a run away. They'll get to reset now and figure out just how they want to attack a new set of downs.
First and 10, it's Pollard. And he's tackled after gaining a handful. Give him 4 that time, so 6 to go on second down.
You know, Kate, one of the reasons it's so hard to run the ball in the NFL is to move grown men off their spot against their will. You get a run play like that, you've done your job. You've moved them against their will, and you've set yourself up for some later success.
Shotgun now for Levis. He's got it. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
You know, Kay, that is the epitome of trust right there. Right, when the ball is let out of his hands, I think everybody on the sidelines in the stadium went, because you throw it in double coverage, and you may question the decision, but it's tough to challenge it when it produces results like that.
Levis from the shotgun. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Tennessee! The Titans pull out in front further, 13-0. No hesitation on that throw. He got the guy he wanted right away, and he got it to him for the touchdown.
You know, it's great, Kate, to draw plays and have all sorts of different options, but it's even better when you don't have to get to your second read. His first broke open just like they planned, and that's 6 in the end.
Folk on now to try the point after. Extra point sent right down the middle. And the Titans drive out to an early 14-0 lead. Stonehouse now to kick this one away. Kickoff taken at the 3. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. They're out and set. First and 10. Start on the ground with Dobbins. And the defense gets there to force a small loss. So before they can set up for another play, we've hit the end of the first quarter. It's a 2-score game early. We're back to SoFi right after this. We're back and all set for the second quarter. Charger football. They have second and pretty long here. From the pistol, it's Herbert. Flush out now to... And this is going to stay with the offense as he makes the recovery.
Well, I think you know the only thing redeeming about that play, Kate.
They got the ball back.
Yeah, well done. Yeah, they got the ball back, but a whole lot longer down a distance.
So a crisis averted a moment ago, but their reward, a really tough third down here. Forced out to his right.
You know, that's a really good play. I know it doesn't get the first down, doesn't keep them on the field, but what it does is it keeps that defense honest. And I promise you, the next time in that situation, they'll have that run in the back of their minds.
The Chargers lined up in punt formation. And he's certainly been staying busy. Once again, he's out to punt and sends this fly. The fair catch taken in at the 28-yard line. So no return on that punt. And the Titans will get set to take over. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Defense showing blitz, Levis. It was there, but he couldn't hang on. That's incomplete. He can't hang on to the pass. And now it's second down.
Yeah, this game, you just can't make it harder than it needs to be. Just get the catch first. Guarantee your yards, and then worry about escaping defenders after the catch.
Throw it again on second down.
You really want those throws to be like clockwork for your offense. Every team needs to hit passes in that short to intermediate range to effectively move the ball.
Last pass unsuccessful, and they have third down here. From the gun, Levis. He has the first over the middle. And he's going to get this up to the 45 before he's brought down. It's a great pickup, 16 yards, and now they've got first down. here with Tajay Spears. And he's brought down for a loss.
I know from the position of the quarterback, Kate, sometimes you hand that ball, you put it in the belly of the running back, and you send him right into the teeth of a buzzsaw. You can feel it from the jump, and that call from the defense, well, it came at the perfect time.
Second and 12 behind the sticks. This one finds Bowler. It's a gain of 12 there. And that'll be a Tennessee first down.
Kate, I can't tell you how good that is. Anticipating the out cut, having the ball on the way before the receiver's head even turns, he puts it on him so that receiver can easily get out of bounds for the nice gain.
Ball on the 45, first and 10. Here's Levis. That pass complete to Boyd. And he's able to get this down to the 36. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. From the 36. Pass taken in by Pollard. And he'll get them enough for a first down.
Just get this guy touches. I don't care how, I don't care when. Just find unique ways to get this running back the ball, and over time, he's going to make you pay.
Ball at the 33 for first down. Motioning one of the tight ends. Trying an inside handoff to Pollard. And this defense offering no room at all up the gut there. No gain. Tackled on the play by Pinafore. No progress on first down, and that'll bring up second and 10.
Big man up front said, not in my house. Let me tell you, Kate, once you're in the grasp of one of those big old fellas on the D-line, you're done. They would say it on the East Coast like this. It's over. Over.
Broke the plane before the snap, and that's going to give the offense some free yardage. Everyone's prepped. It's second down now. On the play fake, it's Levis. He rolls to his right. And they get Thomas. He was trying to make something happen. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
One of the big lessons you learn transitioning from college to the NFL is you can't get it all back at once, offensively or defensively. But this is the right way to go about it now, defensively. You got to get a sack. You got to get something going to stem this momentum. And that might just be the sack they needed.
This drive in jeopardy. Here's a third and 10. Levis. That's caught for the first. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
He just made a difficult throw to the outside look elementary, Kate, and that's not easy. The placement, excellent. And it helps set his target up to put some more yards on that stat sheet.
Just need two more yards that they couldn't get on that last play. Here's first and goal. Pollard will take it in. Touchdown, Tennessee. The Titans take a 20-zip lead. Tony Pollard with the touchdown. Well, this machine has been firing on all cylinders this game, partner. And it continues firing as that lead grows yet again.
And those who've tried to get in the way of that machine you're talking about, namely the defense, well, they've paid the price over and over and over again.
Folk on now to try the point after. The point after splits the uprights. And the Titans stretch their lead to 21. Stonehouse now to kick this one away. That's going to be taken in at the 8. He's got a lane up past the 30. Coverage team tracks him down as the return reaches the 35. So the Chargers start off with good field position as they get ready for 1st and 10. Beginning on the ground here with Dobbins. And they'll make the stop up at the 46-yard line. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And it brings up an L.A. first down.
It's got to be so demoralizing as a defense when you go up against a running back who just keeps those legs churning like a piston in an engine. And that effort's contagious. This entire offense is getting a boost when he busts those tackles.
Herbert on 1st down. Taking a big shot for the end zone. And he can't hang on. Touchdown in his arms. It slips through. 2nd down coming up.
Oh, that is such a bummer. A dropped touchdown right in the end zone. We're going to see how quickly he can flush this one. He better, because they got to make an impact later.
On 2nd down, here's Dobbins. And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot.
I don't know, kid. I didn't think he had it, but that back did. He knew exactly where he had to get for the 1st down. Pops up right away and signals 1st down.
Let's see how they attack this 1st down, Brock, from the 43. Some movement there before the snap. Right side of the line. This is going to back them up. One of the most common penalties in the sport. And the reaction, it's the same every time, Brock. Frustration from the coach as they get backed up 5 yards. They'll run here following the penalty. Gets it ahead, has about 5 yards. Legarius Sneed there for the stop. He'll take 5 on the carry. That gets him back to even. 2nd and 10 now. Running it again with Dobbins. And he's swallowed up in the middle. No gain on the run. Jeffrey Simmons that time on the tackle. No gain on the play, and they still need 10 now on 3rd down.
I know these DNs love to get to the quarterback. I know that sacks many times equals a bigger payday, but doing the dirty work, playing the run well, that's what the best of the ends do in this league.
On 3rd down, Herbert finds a seam down the middle. He makes it in for the Los Angeles touchdown. The Chargers start to fight back for their 1st points of this game. So sensational work by the skill man there, Brock. Anytime you can make your quarterback look that good, you know he appreciates it.
That's a quarterback's best friend, no question. But on the other side, gosh, defensively, you got to get that skill player down. Period. Yeah. End of story. You can't give up that much yards after catch.
Dicker's extra point is up and good. And the Chargers get it back to a 14-point game. Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. Here's Chestnut on the return. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. The Titans and Will Levis set to take over again. And The drive will start out with a first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Now Levis. Out to his wide end. It's a screen. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
You call that receiver screen, and every once in a while, that wide receiver, he's got to be his own blocker. He's got to make the first guy or two miss. That didn't happen. Play goes nowhere.
Wonder what's in the playbook here as they come up on third and 11. The draw to give to Pollard. And he'll charge his way forward up to the 35-yard line. He gets 9 on the carry, and now it's 4th and 2.
You know, that's a case, Kate, defensively, where you just got to keep your eyes on the backfield and be ready if they go with that drop play. Even an extra second to react, it gives them room to operate.
Ryan Stonehouse back out there again to punt it away. Darius Davis returning for the Chargers. And a fair catch made here at the 17. We don't get a return out of that punt. And the Chargers are going to take over deep in their own territory. They'll get this drive started. 1st and 10. On the counter with Dobbins. He's got room to roam here. Space, left sideline, and he's off to the races. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Chargers make it a one-score game in the first half. J.K. Dobbins with the touchdown. Wow, just sensational speed from the back that time, Brock. He found a seam, got through it, and he was gone.
You know, it's one thing, Kate, to have singles hitters, right? And you love those, and you appreciate guys right. That can get on base. But it's the home run hitters that are the difference makers, and what a big-time effort.
Dicker on now for the PAT. Right down the middle, it's good. And the Chargers cut the lead in half. It's down to 7. And just like that, we're back to a one-possession ball game as the kickoff is away. On the return, here comes Tajay Spears. Coverage team gets him down at the 26-yard line. The Titans are being led back out there on offense by their quarterback. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. Levis back to throw. Has him on the quick hitter. And he crosses the sideline a yard or two beyond, looks like the 30. After a good pickup, they've got 2nd and 4. They give to Pollard from the gun. He's going to snag a couple of yards, charging up the gut. Stopped by Deion Henley. Just 2 yards there on the carry. They're going to need another 2 now on 3rd down. It's a pickup of 11. And the Titans will have a first down. We're at the 2-minute warning now from SoFi. The Titans are on the move here. Ball on the 45, first and 10. Throwing is Levis. Into the hands of Okonkwo. And he goes out. Just needed one more step there to reach midfield.
Hey, Kate, you know this from covering the Seahawks calling the preseason game. Pete Carroll was there. If he said it once, he said it 100 times. Stay on top, stay on top, stay on top. You give up a short lot route like that, but just stay on top of the deep threat.
From the 48. That's going to be an incomplete pass on the throw to the right.
That is normally a gimme for this offense, these short throws. But the defense, well, they had just enough influence on that play to force the incompletion.
No connection on the last play, and now it's third down. Looking to throw, Levis.
He fired that one, but they couldn't connect. Okay, I know it's unrealistic to expect a 100% completion rate from anyone on the field. But in this close, we really shouldn't be missing too many throws. Those need to be borderline automatic.
Here comes the Titans punting unit. Ryan Stonehouse will kick it away. And he sends this away. Definitely his best kick of the game thus far. And no chance at a return. He wisely angled it for the sideline and got it down to the 12 before going out. The Chargers on getting the ball back as J.K. Dobbins runs out there. They're out and set, first and 10. Herbert from the gun. Completed over the middle. And they'll manage to contain him after about a 6-yard pickup. Tackled there by Jerome Baker.
The goal of that little drag route is to get him for at least a minimal gain with space to add after that. That picked up a good chunk, and it was nearly a big play.
After a good pickup, they've got second and 4. Shotgun snap to Herbert. Hurst there to grab it. Take him down at the 24-yard line. They get 6 and a first down as well.
You get this big old dude like him in the slot, it's an automatic mismatch advantage. You train a little bit of speed, sure. You sure do get a lot of size. And anytime he's in the slot, you got to assume the ball's going his way.
First and 10, Herbert. Completed to Hurst. And they're going to bring him down just beyond the 30 and the 31. Second and 3 now. Herbert throwing again. Finding Hurst. And he's tackled with the first down yardage. LA uses a timeout here. It's second. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. Markers reset, ball at the 37. Here's Herbert, first and 10. Catch made by Chubb. And he's able to move past the 45 before going out.
I know I could sound like a broken record when I talk about timing and getting the ball out on time and on rhythm, but these outcuts, it is so imperative, and the best of them make it look oh so easy.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and 1. It's Herbert once more. That one falls to the turf. Couldn't hang on. It's incomplete. First time this game they've looked to him. But still plenty of options left on third and short.
You know, the goal on a lot of these short throws is to simply let the receiver create some yards after the catch. That yak. Well, I think he was thinking about the yak before he actually secured the catch.
On third and 1, it's Herbert. Complete. It's a rookie from Georgia. And he does quite a bit of damage take him down.
You throw it in the middle of the field, it's all about anticipation and accuracy. I mean, those are the two keys all the time in my book, Kate. But when you throw it in the middle of the field with all of the traffic, that's where guys with great anticipation and that tremendous accuracy come to life.
Now, just before the break, a timeout taken by the offense, and they can try for some points going into the break. The Chargers sending out Dicker the kicker to add three to the board. This only a chip shot from the right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And it's dropped back down now to a four-point game.
In that close, in the red zone, you know they're upset. They couldn't finish the drive with the touchdown. It's only half the points, but at least there's something to show for the possession.
Well, Brock, barring the touchback, this kickoff should run out the half, so better make that return good as it's away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. Here comes the final play of our first half.
All right, Kate, sit tight. We'll get back to you and Brock in just a moment. But for now, this is our halftime report. It was a strong first half for running back Tony Pollard. He had a touchdown run that helped get his guys this halftime lead. We saw a couple of high-octane offenses getting it done in the first half. Both teams had no problems moving the football. And you'd have to think, the team whose defense shows up in the second half is going to be the one who walks out of here with a victory.
All right, thank you, Coach, and we are back and about set to begin the second half. The first half controlled by the offenses, Brock. Let's see if the defenses can take over in the second half. We're underway. On the return, here comes Davis. In pretty solid field position starting out here, Brock. He's tackled at the 29. Offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. Inside handoff to Dobbins. And he's able to manage a couple on that run.
That's a pretty good stop on first down. This defense now gets a chance to dictate. And that's what all the great defenses want to do, Kate. They want to dictate it on their terms and not just be reacting to what the offense is always doing.
8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. Working from the gun here, it's Herbert.
Well, that window was open down the field, but this league is so fast. And these defenders, well, they closed the gap before that throw could arrive.
So after that prior incompletion, we've got third down. Throwing now, Herbert. He puts some power on a deep one left. And he's there to send that one away, incomplete. Great defensive effort to reject that one. So that brings up fourth and long.
to look downfield at all. I mean, that's just a situation there where it's a better defensive play than the offense executing.
Punt team on the field. J.K. Scott will kick it away. Looking to return from the 29. And before that return amounts to much, they bring him down. It's a 54-yard punt that time. And it's going to be their football coming up. Chunky yards up to the 42. Pickup of 8 on the run, and that sets up 2nd and 2. Again, a run with Pollard, and he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
Looky here, you don't even have to worry now about a third down call as that run moves the sticks. Now that call you had ready though, recycle it, save it for later for that next third down coming.
Football on that 47-yard line, first down. Hands it to the receiver here in motion. Oh, look at this sweep. They're driving forward, but won't get beyond the line. Sent to the ground by Khalil Mack.
Well, that's one of those plays when you call it, you expect to get decent yards every time. Seeing it stop at the line, man, that's deflating offensively.
Again on 2nd to Pollard. Doesn't get much beyond the line, a yard at most. Stopped by Deion Henley. Give him a yard back on the play. Now it's 3rd and 10. Before going down, and that one goes for a gain of 11, and that'll be a Tennessee first down. Gives a Pollard on the option. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. A nice 6-yard pickup. They're going to have 2nd and 4. On the carry, this is Pollard. And the defense gets there to force a small loss.
Hey, range? Range is not an optional feature for middle linebackers in today's game. It's a prerequisite for the job. And this guy definitely has it. Followed that play from the start, and he ended it with a loss.
So now here's 3rd and 5. That is from the shotgun. Couldn't connect right side. It's incomplete. Had that one, but just couldn't see it through. And that leaves them with 4th and 5.
You know, can't we see this all the time at every level of football? You've got to catch it first. It's just like when a receiver receives a handoff. You've got to secure the ball, then let your athleticism take off.
And this kick is good. He needed to get all of it there, and he did. And add 3 to their lead as it extends to 7.
A lot of them may make it look automatic, but you get this deep, and those field goals are far from a certainty. It took all this concentration, every bit of his strength, to send that puppy through.
Stonehouse now to kick this one away. On return, here comes Davis. Coverage team gets him down at the 26-yard line. And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10. The gift to Dobbins out of the shotgun. And he's into the front for a gain of about 2.
If there's ever a play we could call garden variety in the NFL, I think we just saw it right there. That's an uneventful run and a pretty sound stop there defensively.
8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this 2nd down. From the 28, it's incomplete. Should have been a catch downfield, but off his hands and to the ground it goes. That's one he knows he should have had. So they're left facing 3rd and long. Quick on the draw here to Dobbins. Escapes it. Play game 6. It's going to be 4th and 2.
Well, that's a case where defensively you've got to keep your eyes in the backfield and be ready if they go with that drop play. Even an extra second to react, well, it gives them room for a game just like that.
Their punter making his way out now. And he's going to do the honors for the 4th time today. And he finally gets a hold of one here. This is hit far. And he gets his guys a few yards before they bring him down on the return. The Titans and receiver Calvin Ridley back out again on offense. Get this drive started. 1st and 10. On the play fake, it's Levis. That pass complete to Boyd. And he'll take it up to the 30 before being brought down. They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Defense showing blitz. Levis. The cover just too good there. Didn't find a throw that he was confident in, so just throws it away. 3rd down coming up. Shotgun now for Levis.
I'll tell you this, Kate, you gotta be on the same page with one another and get both ends of the play right to execute, both the protection and ultimately completing that ball. They certainly want that play called back.
They'll bring out the punter here. And they can really use a good one here. He sends this away, and oh, this is gonna be a field flipper. Fair catch the signal, and he brings it in at the 23. That punt goes unanswered, no return there. And the Chargers take possession. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. To throw, Herbert. This is really my Josh McCormick. And he goes out of bounds, just short of the 35. Give him an even 10 yards on the play. And the Chargers will have a 1st.
There's no routes on the old proverbial route tree, Kate, that takes more trust than throwing an out route. You're throwing it to a spot and believing your guy can get there.
Finds McConkey. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Shotgun handoff for Dobbins. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
Ooh, I like that. I really like that execution to move the chains. Now that third down call that they had ready, well, they could stick it right back in their pocket for a later occasion.
First and 10 from a yard shy of midfield. A play fake, now Herbert to throw. And Palmer has it. And he's brought down after pushing to that 35-yard line. The big play at some 17 yards. And it brings up an L.A. first down.
As a quarterback, when you throw that curl route, you know it's a tight window, Kate. But the minute that DB turns and can't react to the throw, you put it right on your receiver's numbers. He comes back and gets it and moves the sticks.
They're set up at the 35 now. Now there's the flag. Looks like the jump came from the left side of the line. So tough to stay set when you've got defenders doing everything they can to make you jump, and, well, they got one of them to move that time. Running it after the penalty. And with a nice gain, he runs him down inside a field goal range. They get back eight and now have a second and much more manageable seven. Chargers will have a first.
Not met many receivers in my life that don't love the spotlight, but you got to earn your place there. Easy way to do it, catches just like that, going up into double coverage and making the play anyway.
Straight ahead, here's Dobbins. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs.
Pretty obvious, this defense, I mean, they need more people around the line of scrimmage. But the minute you do that, Kate, start opening up those throwing lanes. This is how balance takes apart a defense.
Going jumbo set on this first and goal. Herbert from the gun. He completes it in traffic. And he's able to get it to the two before the stop.
I'll tell you this, you don't want to make a living throwing into double coverage, but double coverage and still finding a way to beat the defense and haul it in. That's not a situation many players win, and there aren't a lot of quarterbacks willing to make that throw and trust their receiver to get it done.
Dobbins. So they punch it in for six, Brock, and now a conversion away from tying this game back up.
This one just has the feel, doesn't it? The makings of a one-score game in the fourth quarter that could go either way.
Dicker on now for the PAT. Extra point sent right down the middle. And the Chargers bring it back to even. Turn. Here comes Spears. Oh, he's showing some burst on this return. And this return gets to the 30 before he stopped. set, first and 10. Levis to the air now. That throw finds Okonkwo. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he's stopped.
Sure nice to see them looking for their tight ends in the passing game. Such great size to have out there. It really forces defenses to try to find a way to defend them along with everybody else.
In a good spot here, second and inches. The middle, here goes Pollard. And that short gain is enough for a new set of downs.
That's certainly a spot where you could be more aggressive, kid, if you want to take your shots. And some coaches, even the bolder ones, will take the safe play first when they get it from time to time. No third down required now.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Throwing is Levis. Boyd hauls it in. And he made a bid for midfield there, but stopped at his own side at the 49. Second and 3 now. End up running left. Pollard. Duke the defender. Breaks through and he might break away. It's a 23-yard pickup on the play. And the Titans will have a first down.
Best run games in this league have balance. Can run it inside. And as they just showed right there, doing damage on the outside.
After three quarters, we're still neck and neck. Neither side has been able to fully separate. It's been a high-scoring game so far, but we're still tied 24-all to begin the final frame. Still on the move, coming to the line for first and 10. Throwing now from the gun. Down at the 18-yard line.
Oh, man, those defensive players hate slipping quarterbacks. Near impossible to keep them hedged in or corralling behind the line there. It evades them long enough to turn a potential loss into positive yardage.
Let's see what they want to do here, partner. It's second and inches. Levis back to throw. Has him on a quick hitter. And he'll go down here at the 16. Pickup of 2 here. And that'll be a Tennessee first down. Levis. Dumped off to his running back. And he's tackled for a short gain.
Simply part of the job description for any running back in today's game. You out there? You're going to be one of your quarterback's most important safety valves. And you've got to be ready for that check down at all times.
They'll come to the line here, second and 9. Trying the inside hand off to Pollard. And they'll stop him after a short gain to the 13. They push it forward for a yard. That brings up 3rd and 8. Motion out of the slot. Throwing his Levis on 3rd down. Yeah, but a great defensive play. Jarrett loose, incomplete. Trying getting it to Calvin Ridley. And that brings up 4th and long.
Making it harder than it needs to be right there. Just get the catch first, guarantee some yards, and then worry about escaping the defenders and getting upfield.
Fourth quarter.
That field goal gives them the lead for the moment, Kate, but you don't feel comfortable when you look up at that scoreboard. This one is over. and that lead certainly isn't safe.
Stonehouse now to kick this one away. On return, here comes Davis. And this will give them decent field position. The return gets out to the 30. The Chargers back out on offense. They're running back headed out once again. And I think we can agree the plan to keep him out of the end zone, it hasn't quite worked so well for this defense, at least not yet. He scored twice, really being the one his group can turn to for a spark or a big play when they've needed it. First and 10 now from the 30. Shotgun snap to Herbert. Looking slant route complete. And he'll cover up as they touch him down a few yards short of the first.
Good luck defending that short yardage slant. Just not going to happen. There's a reason this is a go-to play for just about any quarterback in every situation.
Second and 3 now. Give right side to Dobbins. And he's brought down for a loss.
Well, they were hoping to get outside and meet those guys at the second level. Well, someone from the second level came to beat him on his turf. And that meeting didn't go so well.
Chance to move the chains here on 3rd and 4. Working from the gun here, it's Herbert. Completed to Hurst. And he's down after getting this up to the 41. One ends up a gain of 6, and it brings up an L.A. first down.
There's no question the greatest concern there was just getting the first down. You want a high percentage throw, and you're not really concerned about big yards. Well, the drag route was perfect. He comes open in the short field. It's easy to zip that throw right in there and reset those chains.
Hurst there to grab it. And he's going to go down right along the midfield stripe. After a good pickup, they're set up with 2nd and short. Going with Dobbins here. Takes one defender, and he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
Go ahead. Find me an offense that won't take that type of efficiency on every snap. Listen, it was good execution, a quality gain, and it moved the sticks.
On the 44-yard line now, 1st and 10. Back to throw. Here's Herbert. Why not go back to it again if it's working? Complete. And he's going to be brought down at the 35-yard line.
Small pass, big result. This dude is just a juggernaut with the football. And once he gets rolling, it gets tougher and tougher and tougher to stop him from playing add-on with those yards.
After a good pickup, they're set up with 2nd and short. It's a give here for Dobbins. And he's able to drive this to the 29 before the stop. He gets 6 on that play, and the Chargers will have a first.
Find me an offense that won't take that type of result every snap. Good execution, a quality gain, and then move the sticks.
A new set of downs awaits him. Here's 1st and 10. Handoff now to the receiver. And the reverse call pays off. Some decent yardage before he's brought down.
That's just a good play to mix up what you're doing and keep that defense guessing. The execution, that's pretty well done too. Creating the space for a solid pickup.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's 2nd and 1. They motion the tight end over. 2nd and 1. Finding Hurst. He's out of bounds inside the red zone, just
sheet for a completion, but that's one of those situations. If you're gonna take a risk and throw an out route, you'd sure like to see a little bit more yardage gained.
Throwing on first is Herbert. Escapes the pocket. Oh, he was on the move, and so is the defense, and they take him down. And the big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
Just a tremendous effort from the defense there. A sense of urgency on first down in the red zone. Got to find a way to knock this offense backwards, and the defense just did.
All right, here we go, second down. Trying again, following the sack. That's incomplete, and he's happy to have that one fall compared to, well, the alternative. Looked like it was gonna be picked there.
Oh, that was such an opportunity lost. They were looking for a way out without giving up any points on the series. And instead, well, he just couldn't quite hang on.
Herbert here, third and long. Short throw is dropped. This one's incomplete.
You know, that's one of those cases, and we see it at every level. He simply took off before he got full possession, and that's simply a drop.
A big try coming up here for Cameron Dicker. This, 42 yards from the right half. Flying down the heart of the lane, and it's good! And in the fourth quarter, that's going to tie the game!
Inspiring a bunch of confidence in himself right there, Kate. Second time they brought him out for a field goal, and second time, well, he's knocked it right through. Trust is earned in a number of different ways on the field, but that's the best way to gain it as a kicker.
Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. Here's Chestnut on the return. He's stopped on the return at the 27. Visitors and Tony Pollard headed back out there offensively. Ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Levis from the shotgun. Looking for his wide receiver there. And it's going to be second down.
That just goes to show you can't take any completion for granted, even on some of the shortest passes in the game plan.
Couldn't connect on first, it's second down. Shotgun now for Levis. And Conco brings it in. And he'll get taken down after advancing this to the 37. And come through with a nice gain there. Gain of 10, first down.
You'll often hear it said, in my life experience, it's true. The NFL is a game of matchups, so much more than any level. And these tight ends, we see it time and again, are such a matchup nightmare down the field.
On the play fake, it's Levis. And a big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
When we think about safeties, I mean, it's just right in the name, right? The safety is the last line of protection in the passing game. We don't think of them as blitzers. But, Kate, let me tell you, for a safety blitz to get home, they got to be great disguisers. They can't show that blitz early. That safety didn't, and the quarterback took the brunt of the contact.
Back To the line they go. It's second down. Another try following the sack. Short pass brought in. Decent gain here, but short of the first. Third and 10. Can this offense get it done? He'll throw it.
As we're into the fourth quarter, we know this. We know that money down cannot be any more important than right now. Both sides are certainly fatigued. You feel it in both their play. But battling through what's been a physical contest all game long, it'll be the key here down the stretch.
So out now comes the punter. And he's going to try to give his defense a long field to defend. And this one is crushed. Wow, beautiful punt here. That is going to go for 60-plus. And he gets his offense in better field position here to start. Up close to the 30. This one returned for 11 yards. And they'll get ready to go on offense. And the drive will start out with a first and 10. Now Herbert to throw. Able to hit Palmer. Complete. This one's brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line. Second and 3 now. They run. Here's Dobbins. And he has them a first down, which they will tackle on the other side of this 2-minute warning. Chargers hurrying to the line as the seconds tick away. Throwing now. Looking right, and he finds him. And this one's worked down to the 33 before being stopped. Options are open here. It's second and inches. Here's an option play to the left. And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down. Tennessee calling its second timeout now. And they are quite frustrated having to call that after giving up the first. Up to the line, and they're set. First and 10. A give to Dobbins. And he'll get this inside the 10 to the line. The Titans call their third and final timeout. And they are quite frustrated having to call that after giving up the first. Set up for the game winner. Let's see how they approach it, starting with this first and goal. They'll put one of the tight ends in motion. Going to the ground again on first. And he'll go down shy of the end zone. They mark him at the 4. First shot gets him 5. Still a couple of looks remaining. It's second and goal.
Hey, I get it on first and goal, right? A lot of teams like to be conservative and limit risk. Even if a run is stopped short, we still got 2, sometimes 3 downs to play with.
Dobbins, and And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
While the offense is looking for a possible touchdown, Kate, it's the defense that's stolen the mojo with that stop. This is how they teach you to defend the goal line.
A big try coming up here for Cameron Dicker. A very short kick here from the right hash. That one is good! And that, folks, is your game winner!
Well, I tell you what, you get to this time of the game, you've got to have that reliable kicker on the sideline to turn things over to. That's the definition of clutch right there as they take the lead.
Dicker all lined up and ready to boot it away. From a couple yards deep, this is going to come out. And he's brought down, Brock, and that brings his ball game to a close. So the Chargers come away with a win in this one. And with overtime in their back pocket, they weren't going to lose it at the end, but they still managed to set up the field goal, and he executed the game winner. What a memorable way to win it. This has been another edition of the NFL on EA Sports. With all our crew here and my broadcast partner, Brock Heward, I'm Kate Scott. It's a win for the Chargers as we say goodbye from Los Angeles.
Keep it up! Keep it up!
Thank you! Thank you.